Hi, welcome to the podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start conversation on Unit 24, Social and Philosophical Foundations of Open and Distance Learning, ODL. Since you are pursuing your studies at an open distance university, you must be familiar with the term open and distance learning, ODL, and you may have knowledge about the ODL system. In this unit, we will be defining the term distance education and open learning. An attempt has been made to give you an overview of the major philosophies that underlie distance education, DE. We have also traced the historical evolution of DE through broadly three distinct phases, namely correspondence education, open education, and virtual education. Lastly, we have discussed the different forms of ODL existing today and also the emerging models in the light of the developments in communication technology that have penetrated all over the world. After going through this unit, you will get a deeper insight with regard to the ODL system. Now, let us move to the point defining open and distance learning. Open and distance learning, ODL, can be simply described as learning or studying at a distance. The teacher and learner are separated both in space and time, bridging the distance and guiding the learning process is effected by means of specially prepared material, self-study or self-learning materials. We may be delivered through various media. For example, print, TV, radio, satellite, audio visual, cassettes, CD, ROMs, internet, video, etc. Professor Kulanda Swami, former Vice Chancellor of the Indira Gandhi National Open University, maintained that distance education is the third stage in the evolution of the education. The first two stages being the Gurukul system of the past and the classroom system of the present. A technological meaning replaces the interpersonal communication of conventional education as two-way communication is possible for both the students and the teacher. This form of education is known by a variety of names. For example, correspondence education, home study, independent study. In Australia, its official name is external system and extramural system in New Zealand. This description carries the vibes of old London external system, which only provided examination but no teaching. The external exam system was introduced by London University in the second half of the 19th century to cater to the needs of a higher education of people geographically distant from the London. In such a system, the learner was not provided any study materials and had to prepare for the exam on his or her own. Today, two terms that are being used almost interchangeably are open learning and distance education, and they are often combined to be known as open and distance learning, ODL. Let us understand the meaning of these terms and what are they connotate. The first is distance education. Distance education, DE, is an umbrella term which describes all the teaching learning arrangements in which the learner and the teacher are normally separated by space and by time. Such a form of education transcends the barriers of time, space, sex, creed, community, and religion, thus breaking the myth of elitism in conventional education. The most complete definition of DE can be attributed to Keegan, who characterized DE as separation of teacher and learner. This is found in many definitions and is central to the whole concept of DE. But Keegan's definition allows for limited face-to-face contact between the teacher and the learner, and among learners themselves, and also through other technological media like audio or video conferencing, etc. The next one is influence of an educational organization or institution. These characteristics has been emphasized by Homburg in his definition of DE. Keegan also adopted it to include the influence of an educational organization or institution in the planning and preparation of learning material that differentiates DE from the private study. The next term is use of technical media. Naturally, the separation of the teacher and learner would require the process of communication to take place in some other way, that is by print, electronic, mechanical, and other devices. Next term is provision of two-way communication. Murray and Homburg definitions of DE stress on this factor that Keegan incorporates in his definition. DE must involve a significant amount of real, known, contiguous two-way communication between teacher and learner for facilitating and supporting the educational process. The next definition is separation of learner from peer group. Obviously, when the learner is studying at a distance at his or her own place, there will be a separation of the learner from his or her peer group. The next term is industrialization of education. This concept stems from the Peter's definition of DE. Keegan accepted Peter's view that DE, the most industrialized form of education, as compared to conventional oral education. The now next term is individualization of learning or student autonomy. Wedmeyer, like Keegan, also emphasized DE to be a form of self-study, as it is based on personal work by an individual learner, more or less independent from the direct guidance of tutors. In other words, a quasi-permanent absence of the learning group throughout the length of the learning process, with the possibility of occasional meeting either face to face or by electronic means. Now, next, let us move to open learning. Open learning covers a wide range of innovations and reforms in the educational sector. It is generally regarded as being a learner-centered system, which is far broader than the distance education. Open learning system aims to redress social or educational inequality and to offer opportunities not provided by conventional colleges or universities. Educational opportunities are planned deliberately so that the access to education is viable to large section of society. Hence, there is flexibility with regard to entry, place, method, but also with regard to the choice and combination of courses, assessment, and course completion, etc. The larger the number of such restrictions left unobserved, the higher the degree of openness. Thus, DE stresses means by which education is achieved. The latter, the objectives and the character of the educational process. As Professor Ram Reddy, the founder of Indian Open University, said, the idea is to provide educational facilities to a large number of people scattered all over, that is, providing greater access to education. Several countries of the world have adopted the open learning philosophy and have started open universities to provide innovative education and to strengthen distance education. The main features of open universities are, like conventional universities, they are autonomous body and are free to take their own decisions. They use multiple media for instructional purposes and for supporting distance learners in their learning endeavors. They have a strong learner support system. High quality materials are prepared by a team of experts. Entry qualifications are flexible and relaxed. The learner can study at his or her own pace, place, and convenience. There is uniformity on the quality of education as students have access to the same high quality education from wherever they want to access it. Here we wind up this conversation, and thank you so much for choosing this podcast.